process of determining how much work we've done to date, and then that will show up. Otherwise, it will show up, you probably hear, I've heard something referred to under this, the first page of the actual budget report that talks about deferred plan of subdivision, paid, not paid, deferred site plan. So we're going to need to establish another column or another row of finances to the point, because it's not a subdivision or it's not site plan at the end of the Ag Resources Act. So we can show that there, we can show that we received it, but just that we spent it. So we need to take that note back to our staff. That's a great point. And thank you, Rob. I let you know.
Any further questions? Seeing none, then I'm going to call for the vote. All in favor? Opposed? Abstained? I have a motion moved by Mary Brett, seconded by Barry White. Be it resolved, correspondence not specifically dealt with, be placed on file. Anyone want to discuss anything? No? Fred?
I thought there was one more letter that somebody placed in the correspondence. Is there another for Val Green?
I can answer that. Me?
Mr. Chairman, that would have been post original agenda going out, so that should be recognized under the correspondence as an additional correspondence received by the members. Did all members receive that in their email, which was the response from Don Pearson to Mr. Hudak? I see some odds going up and down. Okay. So if anyone did not, please talk to Lori. We'll give you a hard copy. Here's a hard copy. So, Mr. Chairman, if you could amend that motion into an additional correspondence. Okay, then.
The motion's fine.
Thank you, Mr.
After that, staff will present their staff report. It will be a PowerPoint presentation. Staff will then recommend a resolution to the hearing board for the applicant as proposed. The applicant and or his agent will speak and also make any comments on the staff report if he so desires. The hearing board will also allow others to speak and, if necessary, the staff, the applicant, and the rebuttal. The hearing board will question, if necessary, both the staff, the applicant, and the agents that they have here. Finally, the hearing board will move in camera if required. Members of the hearing board will move and second the motion. And then the motion will be carried, which culminates in some form of a decision. The hearing board will then move out of the camera. The chair will advise the owner of the applicant of the hearing board's decision. If there is a decision to refuse the permission of the applicant, the chair shall notify the owner applicant of his right to appeal the decision to the Ministry of Natural Resources within 30 days of the receipt of the decision of the reason for the decision. And then finally, a motion will be by the hearing board and set by the authority. Now, all presentations, be they staff or applicant, I would like them to be no longer than 15 minutes. Rebuttal no longer than 10 minutes, okay? And I will be signing that so that we keep this in some form that is workable for us. Okay. I'm not going to make any remarks. Be it resolved, the board of directors now sit as the hearing board. Any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, call for the vote. All in favor? Carried. We are now sitting as the hearing board. Does anyone have community interest in this matter? Seeing none, we'll move ahead. Again, at any time declared, if you do have it, I'll do a roll call of the board. With respect to the application by the TARS, Cookstown Partners Limited, to permit the construction of an addition to the Cookstown outlet mall parking lot expansion, fill placement, and interfere with a wetland on the property, back lots, park lot 7 and 8, concession 14 and 15, town of Lisbon, municipality known as 3311 Highway 89. The Navasota Valley Conservation Authority has adopted regulations under Section 28 of the Conservation Authorities Act, which requires the permission of the authority for development within an area regulated by the authority in order to ensure no.
Aye. Affirm or swear.
I swear. I swear.
That the evidence I'm about to give is truthful in all accounts.
I preliminary work shows that there's probably enough time to go ahead to get the full through, but I believe further studies need to be done to really confirm that. Painted in blue represents the work that Marshall McMonaghan did on their floodplain analysis for their flood elevation of 228.26. The red line shows, according to our analysis, where the flooding would occur as a result of the main Innsville Street flows at 228.5. It virtually says that everything outside of the building